Racers, it's Dave from Arce Engine Building and Fuel Injection Racing Association here in Elk Home, California. We're on our final stages of our Lucas Oil Modified project that include the LQ9 and the FIRA Fast Easy EFI Fuel Injection System. We've got a few more things to go over with to finalize this project. We have the fuel pickup reservoir that we're going to show you, the restrictor plates that we're going to show you, and also programming a little bit on the handheld for the ECM system. So sit tight for a minute, we'll remove the hood, and we'll show you around. So let's go around the engine again here. This is the LQ9, state-of-the-art Gen 3. We're running about 12-to-1 compression ratio. We're running on 91 octane. And we also have our fuel injection system here too. You'll notice that most Gen 3s that you will still have coil packs up here. We've customized a bracket and they are now underneath and we'll look at that later. The other thing is, it's very nice about this is you don't have no distributor where you've got long wires running around and what have you. Now this engine's producing about 600 horsepower. And in the Lucas Oil Modified series, we go to a small track, a big track, and so forth. And that makes it very troublesome because a lot of the competitors switching between a high horsepower engine like this one here, 600, and reducing down to like 450 with the smaller one. What's made it really nice for the fuel injection is a restrictor plate system that we came up with, and we're going to show that to you now. Let's just take a look at the fuel injection system here real quick. Again, this is a Fast Easy EFI. The Fast has been very good to us. It's been very trouble-free. We did have a small fuel feed issue that we needed to correct. We had an external fuel pump, and now we have a internal fuel pump in the fuel cell, and we're going to be taking a look at that in a little bit. We stayed away from that for a little bit because we didn't know how to do penetration into the fuel cell properly, and we have since learned how to do that. So, like I said, we got guys that are doing two engines every other race, changing them out and what have you. So what we've done is we have gone to a restrictor plate package. So what we're going to do is we're building one engine and then a backup engine. And what we're going to do is keep this high horsepower engine in at the small track and the big track. And we're going to limit its horsepower by using a restrictor plate. I'd like to thank Thunderbird Water Jet for cutting these out. They're one of our sponsors and they do a really nice job at water jetting. So anyway, you've got these different restrictor plates that we're experimenting with now. We've done it a few times. It's worked out fantastic. And what's really nice about the Fast system is if you're using this restrictor plate, you can see that the throttle plate here is located really high up into the throttle body. And so when you put one of these restrictor plates on, the butterfly does not come past the bottom of the base here. So all you have to do is just slip this simple restrictor plate in and you could lose 50, 100, 150 horsepower real easily. So that's really another really nice feature with the Fast system. Like I said earlier, we were having a fuel feed problem. This is a little capture reservoir that we came up with. They do have some that are on the market. They're extremely expensive, $400 or $500. We made this for less than $100 in a little bit of time. What we've done is we've located our fuel pump inside here. It's a trap. It goes in the right rear of the fuel cell. As you can see, it's round. It'll fit in a lot of fuel cells very easily. And it's worked out very handy and has solved our fuel feed problem. I would like to open up the throttle here and show you that we're headed to Havasu in a week or so. And so you can see that we have a restrictor plate in there right now. And like I said, this will probably reduce it down to about 475 horsepower is what we predict right now. But that works out absolutely fantastic. So the other thing is along with the Fast, is it has this real handy little handheld here. We're going to plug it in here, and that's our injectors. And it's very, very nice to use. Here's your setup here. You can get live data, your advanced options, and you can get error code. This thing is very simple to use. It only takes you about half an hour to program. And we have been so happy with this. It's been unbelievable. Virtually no problems other than our temporary fuel feed problem that we had at one time. So what we'll do is we'll get away from this and We'll go underneath the car. I'm going to show you the oxygen sensor and the coil packs, and then we'll move on back to the fuel cell and take a look at that. And we'll have a little closing, and that'll pretty much finish up where we lie with this project in the R&D. So here we are underneath the car. I wanted to show you our coil pack system. What we have here is a custom bracket that we make, and then anchored on that are the coil packs. The good folks at DUI sent us their coils to test. They're the Sultans of Spark, and we're in the middle of testing that right now. Also, you can see that how short the wires are compared to the traditional LS1 being on top of the valve cover. That virtually makes this whole package pretty much trouble-free. On the other side, you basically mimic the same type of thing, same type of bracket and what have you. Like I said, it makes this whole system pretty much trouble-free. The other thing that I'd like to do is take you back here and show you the oxygen sensor. This is the oxygen sensor that goes to the ECM for the fast, easy EFI, and it's a wideband 5-wire, and does all the calculating for the air-fuel mixture and makes this very simple for us. So what we'll do is we'll head back to the fuel cell next. So one of the small problems that we came up with in running the fuel injection system is we had a temporary loss of fuel in one of the races. And we had figured out that the fuel was getting away from the pickup. So I'd like to show you around on what we did to correct that. We were originally running an external pump, and we were doing that because we weren't sure how to penetrate the fuel cell properly with the electrical wires. So we have since did some investigating and found out how to successfully do that. And if you remember, I was talking about this little mechanism that we came up with earlier. They make this, this is like a little trap type reservoir. ATL does make one. It's extremely expensive, about $400 or $500, but we came up with this for about less than $100. And what this does is this will fit in the most common fuel cells. If you take off these nuts right here, this will actually slide in there and go to the back here where it belongs. And this will this is where your fuel pump will sit. Your wires right here will penetrate the fuel cell. You can buy this connector from ATL as well, and it'll come over and go to your pump and sit right here, and this will basically trap the fuel. The other thing is we have a fuel feed, and we also have a return line. The return line in the fuel cell comes over here and goes into the top of this, so it constantly feeds this. So if there's any sloshing going on, it has its best chance of keeping this full. We have had no problems since we have migrated this into our system. So with that being said, that pretty much covers everything. We'll go to a little closeout here in just a moment. In closing, this has been a fantastic 2-year program migrating the LQ9 and the fuel injection into the Lucas Oil Modified Series. I'd really like to thank Lucas Oil for allowing me to do this project. I could never do this without my crew chief, who has been deeply involved in this, and that would be Chuck Nevin. I'd like to thank him as well. The others would be just our general sponsors. I'd like to thank Thunderbird Water Jet Service, Center for Family Health, Dancing, and also the great support from Ben Strader at EFI University. He's been very instrumental in pushing on me to get this accomplished, and it's been a great ride. So with that, I hope to see you guys out there, and hopefully we'll get some phone calls and see if we can't get some other tracks to start converting over to the new Gen 3.
Times have changed and times are strange. Here I come, but I ain't the same. Mama, I'm coming home. Time's gone by.